I'm Kwame Holman for the rundown, filling in for Hari Srinivasan for the Friday doubleheader, but a single header today with Mark Shields. Mark, David couldn't be with us, but that's all right.
It's all right. It's more time for me, Kwame.
Absolutely.
Okay, thank you.
Big news today. What's your first take on Hosni Mubarak's departure?
I guess more than anything else, just a feeling of celebration and joy that from the bottom up, this was not orchestrated by foreign powers. There were no heavy artillery. There was no virtually no gunfire of any sort that I can detect. I mean, it's just a marvelous moment and the great possibility. And I think it changes for an awful lot of us in the West the face of the image of Islam. I mean, that all of a sudden you've got a truly democratic movement that has to upset and anger Al-Qaeda. I just think it's a marvelous moment. We don't know which way it will go, but I think we now have a reason to hope for the best.
Mark, let's turn to some questions to you from Reddit.com writers who questioned David last week. The first one is from Reddit user BBK13. I've seen a lot on the blogosphere about the future of the American worker, mostly discussing the kind of jobs that will be available and what those jobs will look like vis-a-vis wages, conditions, etc. Does Mark think that in the future there will be the same kind of broad middle class that we have seen in the past?
Boy, all the evidence points the other way. We've seen the squeeze on the American middle class. We've seen a wider gulf in income in this country, a concentration in the top 1% of the economic in income growth. The 40 years after, 30 years after World War II was a marvelous period in this country during which prosperity was widely distributed, the country rose as one, and at the mid to late 1970s it changed. And there's been a divergence ever since. I mean, good paying, we see a loss of a lot of industrial manufacturing, good paying jobs, where a single wage earner could provide for a family and educate children and have a, you know, really a good life. So I hope that we start to move in a policy direction that encourages that and encourages the growth and preservation and strengthening of America's working families and middle class. I mean, because to me that is one of the true achievements of our country, and it's tarnished and been damaged over the past generation.
Reddit user RX More Cowbell.
No, not him again.
I know it's early, but what do you predict will be the biggest attack issue for the 2012 presidential election?
Oh, boy. I wish I could predict. I mean, I think you'll get all the predictables, religion. One of the most interesting things about Barack Obama as president is that even those who don't like him, can't stand him, want him defeated, acknowledge the fact that he is a real family man, cares about his children, and he and his wife have, from all appearances and all evidence, a very good relationship. So that is one area that I'd be frankly surprised if that is the case. I mean, it's certainly that there were more than a few attacks on President Clinton when he was running for re-election. What would they be? It'll be the traditional week on foreign policy. I tell you this, as far as the Egyptian is concerned, presidents never get credit for their foreign policy achievements in American voters. I mean, George Herbert Walker Bush was there when the Berlin Wall came down. Germany's reunited. He put together the coalition in the Persian Gulf, got the UN and the Democratic Congress to ratify it, and got basically Japan and the Gulf states to pay Germany to pay for it. And 4 days won a blitz and drove Saddam Hussein out of Kuwait. You know, a year later, he gets 38% of the vote and Bill Clinton's president. Jimmy Carter pulls off historic achievement, bringing Israel and Egypt together, Camp David. 13 days of meetings, determination, skill, tirelessness, stubbornness on Carter's part. What happens? Jimmy Carter carries six states against Ronald Reagan. So, the Obama people should not rely upon Egypt, and we hope it's a burgeoning democracy as a voting issue in their favor in 2012.
Don't look for that. No. All right. Mark Shields, thank you very much here on this Friday single header with Mark Shields. I'm Kwame Holman for The Rundown.